Hey, welcome back. It's Dueling Excel Podcast, episode 145, Dateify 2013-12-20 with Uvuvu.
Live from Highline Community College, it's time for another Dueling Excel Podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'm here with
Excel is Fun.
Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is our episode 145. How do we convert these strange dates into real dates? All right, so if someone has dates here, this is year, month, day, and we need to convert those into real dates. I'm going to use Alt-D-E, data, text to columns. It doesn't matter what I choose here. We're going to make sure that there are no delimiters. And in step three, simply say that it is Y-M-D, like that. And here we will even move this out to before, so that way we can see the before and the after. Click Finish, and we get the real dates there using data, text to columns.
Wow, that is the trick. That's the point right there.
You know, the first time I tried that, it's like, wow, I can't believe. It was just a desperation move. There's no way that this will work. I figured I was going to have to come down here and use the equal date function, and for the year, use the left of this, comma, 4. Now, I wonder, do I have to add 0 to that? I'm going to try it without. We might have to come back. And then the mid of this, comma, 5, comma, 2. That means starting position 5 for length of 2. And then the right of that, comma, 2. Closing parenthesis. Make sure the last parenthesis is black. I learned that from Mike. And we get the correct answer. Double-click to shoot it down. So there's two different ways to go. Mike, let's see what you have.
Wow, I love that text to columns. That is the only way to do. Well, if I have to do one without a formula, one with a formula, I'm going to use the bulky and difficult flash fill. And I actually learned this from Mr. Excel's book. Sometimes, because you have 0, 7, there's a 0 there. If you try to flash fill and put 7, 14, right? So if I were to 7/14/2001 and tried to flash fill that with data, flash fill, or control E, it wouldn't get it right.
Control E? What the heck? What is control E?
Control E, that's flash fill. So I learned this from Mr. Excel, control 1. I'm going to format this first to help it understand that lead 0. So I'm going to come down to custom, MM. That'll give me the lead 0 slash DD slash YYY. Now, I'm going to have to give it two examples. So 07/14/2001, and I'm going to have to choose my second example, 11/15/2009.
Hey, why'd you leave the blank?
I'm picking two examples. There's a 1-1 and a 0-7. I'm thinking it needs two. Right. And then control E, and sure enough, that worked. Hey, you can. I would never use flash fill for this. Anytime there's a lead 0, times also give you trouble. But if you mess around long enough, then you figure maybe you'd need some formatting and a couple examples. There you go.
There you go. Yeah, Chad from Microsoft, who put flash fill together, said that with numbers, it was really, really tough to try and figure out what the pattern is. It's much easier when you have words for flash fill instead of numbers.
So yeah, why would you ever do flash fill when you have text to columns?
Text to columns, year, year, month, or YMD format.
Hey, we're going to do the text function, and we're going to take this value and then add a number format. Now, we really want
there's no way that the text function is going to solve this. How are you going to solve this with a text function?
Oh, no, we can do it with the text function.
No way.
Yeah, we're going to take this, and we're going to add a custom number format. And check this out. We really want MM, D, D, Y, 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 right? But we can't do that. I'm going to put 0, 0, and I need to insert a slash. So I'm going to use backslash, forward slash. The backslash says whatever comes next, I'm going to insert this character. Then 0, 0, and then my V, backslash, forward slash, and then 0, 0, 0, 0 for the year.
Now, wait a second. First off, I love this because it's going to confuse my coworkers. They're not going to understand what the V is. But that data that you have is YMD, so you need 4 zeros before the first V to get the year, right?
This is going to work. Let's
There's
try
no
it.
There's no way this is going to work.
Plus, yeah, sure it is.
No, it's not. you need a comma. Okay. But even with the comma, it's not
going to
work.
Definitely going to work. Look at that.
No, it's the year 0714. Put 4 zeros. No, 4 zeros first. In the first batch, 4 zeros.
Boop, boop, boop.
Nope. One too many.
Boop. Boop, boop, boop.
And you have 500, that should be 4.
So
that's going to look like a date. That's going to look like a date.
This is going to be crazy.
And then can you use the date value of that?
Oh, watch this. No, I'm going to add 0.
No way.
Sure. Oh, look at that. Control 1. What? It's actually going to work?
No way. Get out of here.
That is insane.
He sets me up. You know, I got up at 6 a.m. this morning. I flew out here. And Mike says, go ahead, we'll do this duel. And he lets me do the good ways, right? And then here at the end, he throws this insane formula in.
Hey, I'm not that smart. I'm just a guy having fun with Excel. I learned this from Barry Houdini.
Crazy.
Barry Houdini at the MrExcel Message Board, the most amazing place in the world.
Yeah,
actually,
you never told me about this.
Oh, it's amazing. Actually, I saw him do it with a time. And just out of kick the other day, I tried it with the data, and I was like, you got to be kidding me.
That is crazy. Already this trip to Seattle is worth it for that trick right there. Back with a point to me, point to you for that. That's crazy. And a point to Barry Houdini for that cool trick. All right.
No, I'm going to give a point to you for text to comms and then 10 points to Barry Houdini.
That's good. All right. Well, hey, That was amazing. All right, well, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel.
And Excel is fun. Woohoo!